Hello. One of the things I'd like to do is spend a few minutes to demonstrate the concepts of undermining and tunneling, because those seem to be issues that a lot of clinicians struggle with and really have some concerns about what exactly those mean. When we talk about tunneling and undermining, those are really a type of dead space that we see in the wounds. One of the things that we do as part of our comprehensive wound assessment is to look at the length, the width, the depth of the wound, and also for the presence of any dead space, such as tunneling or undermining. When we talk about tunneling, a tunnel is generally a tract in the wound. It usually is one directional. Using this particular mannequin, I would like to just demonstrate what tunneling looks like. So whenever you're assessing a wound, you're going to be using a sterile Q-tip. Typically, if I am going to be measuring the length, the width, and the depth of the wound, this patient's head would be at 12 o'clock, the feet would be at 6 o'clock. So I would be measuring the length this way, head-to-toe orientation. I would be measuring the width this way, side-to-side orientation. And then I would be measuring the depth using a sterile applicator and finding the deepest part of the wound and holding it perpendicular to the base of the wound. And that would allow me then to determine what my depth is. That's pretty straightforward for most clinicians. But when we have tunneling, tunneling is generally a tunnel or tract. And in this case, I have a patient who has a tunnel. This is a patient, his head is here. Therefore, if I am using the face of the clock, which is what you would use to describe the orientation, this would be a tunnel that measures approximately 3.5 centimeters. And it's located at about the 7 o'clock position. So we have a tunnel at the 7 o'clock position. That is a tunnel. In terms of undermining, undermining really refers to an area where the edges of the wound are not attached. There is basically a shelf or a lip underneath the wound. So to measure undermining, what I would do is, again, use a sterile tipped applicator. And I would find, and you can see as I hold this Q-tip parallel to the wound, that it goes right in and there is a little shelf or a little lip, if you will. So in this case, I am finding that there is undermining from here all the way over to here, quite a bit of undermining. So what I would use, again, is the face of the clock, and I would describe this as approximately, 2 centimeters, I would say, of undermining from about the 11 o'clock position all the way over to the 2 o'clock position. So that is undermining. This is tunneling. The other thing that's very important, just to reiterate, is whenever you have any depth or dead space in the wound, it's absolutely critical to pack that wound, not to overpack it, not to pack it too tightly, but to just gently fill those areas. That's a very critical part of your wound care. Thank you.